I'm back. He the only reason why do not get violent. Hey, cause he gave me patience. Hey, swear to God, make sense. Hey, when you making bands, can make friends. Cause I know they tryna shit like Ray Bans. Got a bad little shorty wasting. And I own it, I ain't gotta pay rent. Hey, I know we the ones that ain't them. Pull both hands together and I'm saying amen. Cause I'm going big, going big. Everywhere I go, they know the click. Too many wins, they know the shit. They was hating, know they sick, acting like
hey everybody, it's the coach. You're tuned in to Sunday Night Football on EA Sports. On tap is what should be a pretty good matchup between the Washington Redskins and the New York Giants. I'll join you again at halftime to look at some of these stats and scores from earlier this afternoon. But for now, it's Sunday Night Football. And on the call, as always, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
And thank you, Coach. We are across the Hudson from Midtown Manhattan at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it. This crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Washington Redskins and the New York Giants. Alongside my partner Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, and Charles, you take a look at this Giants ball club. Their long winning streak finally came to an end last week. A disappointing game for them, but still a heck of a run.
Indeed it was. What a great job by them putting together a streak. Now let's see how they rebound after a defeat.
Meanwhile, for the visiting Redskins, they come in just in an absolute free fall. Losers of 7 in a row.
And this is where you turn to your best players and look at them and say, can you guide us out of this? We've got to be better than what we've shown.
Season is upon us. We've got the gift of the NFL as we're underway here in week 16. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So out comes the Redskins offense now onto the field. They are led out by the 15th overall selection in 2019, former Ohio State Buckeye Dwayne Haskins.
Coming off of a loss their last time out, I think he's just seeking to make a bigger impact on the game. He threw a touchdown pass, didn't throw an interception. I think he just wants to jump those numbers up in terms of flinging it around and letting his receivers get into the end zone.
Now Haskins on first down. Well, he's going to take a shot right away.
Why would you throw that out of bounds?
Wind up incomplete. Trying to give his man room to run under it, but it's second down. And a quick look at Washington's offense.
So let's all work together on this one because it's natural to just watch the football. But I want all of us to watch the center of this offensive line, the center and the two guards. They've got to be able to control the point of attack, and they didn't do such a good job on that last play. Plenty of opportunities to redeem themselves. They'll have to take advantage of that and start to make progress.
First carry for Darius Geis. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27. A look now at the starters for the Giants defensively. They were quite formidable in the win over the Eagles a week ago.
And it was the pass rush that really keyed their victory. Got to the quarterback 6 times for sacks and plenty of other turbulence in the pocket for him as well.
An early tough test on the opening drive. This is 3rd and 8. Third down. Here's Haskins. Keeps himself upright. Haskins hit the football. And the Giants have it. It's picked up. And they'll be inside the red zone with a ball at the 16-yard line.
Where is it?
Some guys just have a knack for creating turnovers. He's got a little bit of that going. He forced a fumble last week, another one there.
And it just drives teams crazy because they realize that certain guys, as you said, have that knack, and they're trying to keep them away from the action, away from the ball. But the best ones have that overwhelming desire, that overwhelming need to get to the football and make it happen, and that he does.
opening minute, and already a trip to the red zone. They come up first and 10 at the 16.
It hasn't even been a full 30 seconds, full minute yet.
The first carry for the former Nittany Lion. This is Saquon Barkley. And he'll be stopped after a gain of only a couple down to the 15-yard line. These are his numbers from last week's contest. And Charles, how do you think he ran the football?
I thought he definitely had his moments. I did think that they could have utilized him a little bit better, and I'm definitely going to keep an eye on him to see how they're going to use him this week. You can't block me.
On second down, here's Barkley.
And touchdown, Giants.
Giant touchdown. 15 yards as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. And they're able to run it in. It started with a battle in the trenches. They won there.
1 minute.
And they got in for 6 points.
The Giants scored a touchdown.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out how are we going to slow down this running game, because on that particular play, they had no answer.
A try here for the extra point.
And the extra point is not good.
Oh, this is blocked. This is going the other way.
Woo!
But he doesn't get far. They're able to stop him. Yeah, and after all that, the extra point attempt unsuccessful.
The extra point is no good.
But there's a blocked extra point. I remember playing in... We had one of those go against us. I remember our kicker and our holder told the head coach, just relax, coach. Why are you yelling? Don't worry about it. It's just 1 point. Oh, my. Those coaches see a point is gold to them, because you never know how it's going to turn out later.
Exactly. That's why I was just going to say first quarter. We'll see if this has any implications as the game goes on.
I still can't believe they told the head coach to relax. Whoa.
Bad move. This fielded a few yards into
the
end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Out comes the Washington offense as we get a look at the playoff race in the NFC. And with a final fortnight of games upon us, teams jockeying for position. Some of these games really starting to take enormous importance, as they always do this time of year.
I like how you use fortnight.
I'm impressed, don't you?
I am impressed. That means 2 weeks, if I'm not mistaken.
That does.
But how about exactly?
Why are they talking about Fortnite on that?
How much importance is placed on these games? Look, everyone talks about every game's important. When you get to this time of year, maybe that importance gets quadrupled. And that's where we are right now, to see who can make their last run, their last push to get into the playoffs.
From the 29, Haskins. And they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete.
He's a little trigger happy right there, and it turned into an ill-advised throw into their zone.
Well, we know he has confidence. He'll throw it any place, anytime, anywhere. That time it fell incomplete. Now Haskins. Goodwin able to haul it in. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. A Redskin first down. The pickup, 15 yards.
Timing is everything, and they work on this cut all the time. They work on all the timing patterns, and this time it paid off for them. Worked him to the center of the field, cut it to the outside, ball's delivered, gets both feet down for the completion.
On first down, this is Geis. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. No gain on the play there, second down. Throwing on second down.
And set.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. O'Shane Zimenez racking up sack number 12 for him on the year.
They just gave up a sack there, and if I'm not mistaken, they gave up four last week, didn't they?
Yes. And just looking really porous, aren't they?
They really are, and I'm wondering if I'm going to have to start thinking about keeping the tight end in, maybe a back, someone to help assist, because right now, their quarterback's been getting hit a lot in the last couple of games.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Now Haskins, third and long.
And will it be intercepted? No.
Unable to connect. Incomplete.
No, wait. Incomplete.
Credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender is making sure his guy couldn't hold on to the football. So I don't see anything to warrant the flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket.
He dropped.
So on fourth down, the Redskins will call on Tressway to punt it away. Only two punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. And a nice job here to down this one right on the five-yard line.
That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the five-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb. As the Giants head back out there, let's take a look at the playoff picture of the NFC. And the division title out of reach, we know that. This is as good a spot, Charles, as they're going to get. That first wild card and the number 5 overall seed.
So it's just a matter of adjusting now, isn't it? And what I mean by that is mentally. Every team starts the season thinking, let's go for the number 1 seed, right? Being the top team. Number 2 is pretty great, too, because you get the
win complete.
And you're at home after that. But it doesn't matter at this point. Just getting in, and you just sit down and talk to your team. Would you rather go on the road and deal with someone, or would you rather stay at home for the playoffs? Let's go on the road and go take someone out.
Solid catch there for a man who's been so brilliant this year. Worth pointing out, as we were talking about earlier, there has never in the 60-year history of the award been a pass catcher, tight end, or wide receiver that has taken home the MVP trophy.
And the best receivers I've talked with, they know that stat, and it drives them crazy because they understand that without a quarterback, they don't make the plays that they make. They also don't feel like they get enough credit for bailing out some of the throws that quarterbacks make.
Absolutely. It takes two to tango. Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete. They were trying to get it there to Sterling Shepard, and now it's second down.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
On the draw, this is Barkley.
And we want to win.
And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. First down, Giants on a pickup of 14. Last week, of course, the great performance, over 200 yards. He still wants to be fed.
And they should. That's exactly what you should do. I have not yet met a running back that's run for over 200 yards that says the very next week, hey, let's back things up.
I don't need it as much.
No, they want it more and more. They're going to be ready to go because they think that's going to happen naturally now.
So a solid run by Saquon Barkley and another first and 10 here. They'll run it now out of the gun. And no room to maneuver there. Give him a yard up to the 47.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
On second down, Barkley. And he's got it across the midfield, striping into Washington territory. 4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave him with a third and about four more for a first. They'll set up a throw. He's going to fire one.
Oh, no, I hit the wrong button again. Wait.
And no, the throw there going to be incomplete. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play. And the officials are instructed, if there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down. Fourth down, so on is the punter, Riley Dixon. He was called on three times in the win last week as his first one here's away. And that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. The Redskins offense now, they head back onto the field. The partner just looking at some of the struggles they've had this season. The playoffs are not in their future. As they start to peer toward the offseason, what moves might they make?
I think the running back position. And I know we talk all the time about the NFL being a passing league. But the teams that run the ball effectively, they're the ones that go deep into the playoffs and go to the Super Bowl. They have to upgrade here. And you and I both know in recent years in the draft, people have shied away from taking a runner early. But there's that special one there. I say they go get him.
They start on the ground with Geis. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. A look at the numbers for Geis a week ago. 13 carries, 56 yards.
They've lost a bunch of games in a row now. They've got to start thinking a little bit differently, maybe a little bit outside of the box. Find other ways to move the football. I don't know if you're going to do it through the air or maybe change up how you establish your run game.
Up at the 29 now, they'll head to the line. Second and a yard. This is Geis. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up third down. Plays like we just saw there, that's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs who are putting together a team, a lot of them say, we're going to build from the inside out. Because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game. And that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
They'll try and get it with Geis. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. Give him 7 yards on the play as they do pick up the third down conversion.
I know the game's changed. A lot of people would say it's evolved. Look, I'm a little bit Neanderthal, okay? I love this. No exotic formations, no misdirection. Just line up and run the darn ball, pick up the first down. I love it.
Yeah, third and short, that's what you're supposed to do. Like you said, old school, smash mouth football.
You know what I say? Same thing about basketball. Smash mouth basketball.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. On first down, it's Haskins. Slings this deep from McLaurin.
He's the team behind
us. And that is caught one-handed. Oh, my, he pulled it in. Big yardage that time for the Redskins. 57 yards.
Tell the truth, partner. You didn't think he was coming down with that one, did you? Come on, tell me the truth.
No, I did. I'll tell you what, though. A one-handed grab of that length. Talk about giving your team a little juice.
Oh, big time. I mean, everyone's going to be excited about that one. Whether you're on the field or not, it permeates its way through the entire team. And I can't wait to see what they do on the next down.
Redskins with their first trip to the red zone thus far. They're looking at a first and goal from about the 9.
All I do is take something next
to looking to throw, Haskins. That is caught at the 7-yard line. He'll get only 2 there, and it's second and goal.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
The line of scrimmage, the 7 now on second and goal. Back to the ground game now with Geis, and he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. It'll be a loss of 1, and that's going to bring up an interesting 3rd and goal. Good opening quarter for him. Remember, he had the sack earlier. Now a tackle for loss, another tackle for loss.
He's really making it tough on the play call, though, isn't he? Because it's one thing to try and adjust when a guy is disrupting your running game. But when he's messing up your passing game as well, they may have to devote at least a second guy to him to try and keep him away from their plays.
And back at the 8 now, 3rd and goal. On 3rd and goal, Haskins. Haskins hit.
Another fumble.
And the Giants have it. It's picked up.
Is this going to be a fumble recovery for a touchdown? 50. No, he's too slow.
The 40. And they finally put an end to this return, but not before he's all the way down to the 37.
No, he's too
always
slow.
Fun to watch a big boy pick it up and go. He may need a little oxygen on it. He may need a lot of oxygen on the sideline.
Not only that, how about you and me trying to balance ourselves up here because you can feel the shaking all the way up to the booth. That big guy trying to get it to the house.
Saquon Barkley and the Giants offense set to kick off their next drive. And you see his numbers from a week ago. He was up over 100 yards then, and he's already hit pay dirt here once in this one.
We always talk about quarterbacks and receivers getting into rhythm, right? Really feeling good, finding each other downfield. I think running backs operate the same way. They can hit a good rhythm and a good stride. He's carrying it over from last week.
Now a fake on the give here as they try the run pass option. Open target here, Darius Slayton. And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. 17 yards and a giant first down. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense.
Yes, it is. You got to play the game and drive up the street. Listen to that shit.
I went out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
Yeah, shit. He did. A first down carry for Barkley. This will be a 5-yard pickup as they move it from the 20 to the 15. Well, they're making an effort to get the ground game going tonight. So far, it's working.
I like what we're seeing from the offensive line. They seem to have the leverage going and they're controlling things and reestablishing the line of scrimmage, moving that defensive front backwards.
Yeah, not trying to let me
like what the runner's giving us, too. It appears that he's been waiting all day long to get out here and take off. 56
miles. 56 miles. Looking to throw.
You get me a touchdown.
And that is incomplete.
Oh, never mind. I guess I'm going for a 3-point conversion.
Those throwing windows get a lot tighter near the end zone, don't they? And here's the thing. You already probably have 3 points in your hip pocket. You force a throw here and give up an interception, you come away with nothing.
Especially tough in the middle third of the field where he threw that one. And his kick here is good. And that will make our score 9-0. So unable to convert for the touchdown inside the red zone, but they do come away with three.
Yeah, it's a 32-yarder. That's essentially an extra point nowadays, right? Because it's 33 as a general rule for these guys. So it should be a simple kick. But you know what's really strange nowadays? When they miss an extra point, I think they carry that with them longer than missing a field goal because an extra point's supposed to be automatic.
Absolutely, and I would think even field goals inside of 30 yards, even though they're substantially shorter than a PAT, it just has a different feel, doesn't it?
A different feel, a different vibe. That's what I get from all the kickers I talk to. They always say, if I miss an extra point, that's the one that bothers me more.
Here comes the field general leading his offense back out there for the next possession. And maybe he's starting to wave the white flag a little bit. He's playing pretty well, but the pressure, it's got to him.
Has to find a way to step around it, step through it, or just handle it. Because as you mentioned, he's having a pretty good day overall. Just the hits keep coming and taking those sacks. That's not the way that they want to finish a ball game with their quarterback on the ground so much.
He'd like to stay upright. When he's been upright, he's been pretty good. Haskins and the Redskins come up first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Here's Geis, and he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
That didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
Fumble again?
Loose. And the Giants have it. It's picked up. And he'll bring it
down. There's always the slow nigga picking up the ball.
He's trying to get it to Terry McLaurin.
Whenever I see a team turn it over on back-to-back drives,
damn, because somebody fans on a defense, pick up the ball.
I know one person's blood pressure who is starting to rise, and that's the head coach.
Absolutely. And when's it going to go down? When
they stop fumbling? Because I'm pretty sure he got fumbled three times. That's the third time they fumbled it.
And only if they manage to win the game.
And New York set to take the field. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had the field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for three, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get three, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
They'll try and run four with Barkley. Down at the two. Broke through first contact, but ultimately stopped shy of the goal line. Good yardage on first down. Now can they punch it in on second and goal? And Barkley will try to punch it in. And that play going absolutely nowhere.
He didn't even run. He ran in place.
Before he could get out of the backfield. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And that is going to set up third and goal.
That's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that. Got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
Now from back at the five, this is third and goal. Here's Barkley, and he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the six. Defensively, they rally the troops to force fourth down after that 7-yard pickup back on first. Well, if this defense can hold them to a field goal here, what a win that would be.
Not just a win on the possession, but psychologically take over the ball game. But this started with first and goal, so they were in four down territory right from the beginning. I say you finish it off and go for the touchdown.
And for the second time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. From the left half, a chip shot here.
With all field
and
goals.
Kick is right I'm there. Here. It's good. And that will bump up the lead again to 12-0. So they recovered the fumble, but ultimately could not take advantage of the short field.
Definitely a lost opportunity right there. I mean, they were in prime position to put six on the board. Ended up settling for three.
The kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Out comes Washington's offense as they get set to take over here. And last time they coughed it up, led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal, but still, they're not happy about it.
Could you sense the relief, though, when they only gave up the field goal and they were able to trot back out on the field and start this drive? A little more pep in their step because they didn't cost their team a touchdown. But they know they've got to do it a lot better than they did on the last possession.
Coach will just be relieved, though, if they recoup with a score here, right?
I think Coach would be ecstatic to see them pick themselves back up and now take it downfield, punching the end zone without turning it over. The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. They'll run with Geis. And boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Second down, Haskins. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end.
Hold on for that ball, buddy.
Brandon just marked that under the category of just not successful. Trying to throw the ball, just didn't work on that one.
Completed it. No yardage. On third down, Seymour. And he's going to come up a few yards short. Brought down at the 45. It's a pickup of six, but it's not going to be enough. And the punt team's going to be summoned on fourth down.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice, solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
Here's Tressway now as he'll kick it away for the second time. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. And New York set to take the field. They find themselves in a good-sized hole here, and a good-sized hole early on in this game as they come up on first down.
Touchdown.
He's set up to throw. He's gonna fire one.
Getting a touchdown.
Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. A big pickup of 38. A cool little accomplishment for him passing the football. 25,000 yards. He just surpassed that for his career.
When he was a little guy in the backyard just throwing it around probably with his dad, he thought about playing in the NFL. He dreamed of it. But to put up these kind of numbers while doing so, that's got to be kind of cool for him. He'll enjoy the heck out of thinking about that when this one is over.
So the big play moves him all the way across midfield to the 40 now for first and 10. A give to Barkley out of the gun.
I'm running it. Get off me!
And he gets this one inside the 15.
He has the 11.
Too shy of the 10. A big run there. 29 yards at a first.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
Shot us again.
They keep it with Barkley on first down.
And touchdown, baby.
For a giant touchdown. Saquon Barkley with his second touchdown in this opening quarter. And the Giants are able to add on to their lead. And a pair of rushing touchdowns now for him in the first quarter.
And I'm liking what I'm seeing from his big guys up front because they're winning the leverage game. How many times have we talked about low man wins, right? Move the defensive front aside, create those gaps and holes. He's found his way through them for two touchdowns.
And after both of those touchdowns, he went right up to that O-line and hit each of them on the helmet.
That's a smart man. You know what else he should do? If this continues, take them all to dinner.
The call is to go for one and kick the extra point.
Oh, snap.
And again, it's no good. A few boo birds coming out as he's missed his second extra point here in the first half. So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. Out comes the Redskin offense now as they get set to begin another possession. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him, all right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field in this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game. Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. So they had the run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on second and 10. Here's Haskins. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
And the Giants will go with 6 defensive backs here on third. From the gun, Haskins on third down. And that will be incomplete. Thank you.
Well, let's get the ball.
Here's
there.
Tressway now, as he's on to punt for Washington. And he's getting a workout here in this first quarter as he gets it away. This is taken at the 23. We are in for a good one as we're through one on EA Sports. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. They'll come out throwing here on first down. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And they bring it to the ground just shy of midfield. It's a gain of 11 and a Giant first down.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection.
Oh, will this be a touchdown? Nope, just completion.
What a grab at the 8. A big play there for the Giants. 43 yards. But one thing's for sure, they're going to have to come up with something at halftime, because he is absolutely roasting them right now.
They're going to go through the whole litany of things, changing coverages, you know, what are we going to do, put a man on him. The big thing to me is treat it like a good pitcher treats pitching a game. Change your timing, change your location. So sometimes you're up on him, sometimes you're back. Just change up the looks that he sees and make him just a little bit more hesitant.
The chain gang hustling to catch up. Here's first and goal from just inside the 10. He'll look to throw. This will be caught at about the 5.
Oh, that's good.
And they'll get this from the 8 to the 5. Pickup of 3. 3 yards is the gain that time. Second and goal.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. Now Saquon Barkley. And he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all. No gain on the play there. They're going to need to come up with something better here on third and goal. Defensively, I think they can smell a stop. Ball right around the 5 here brings up third.
And I think what they've done is they put doubt in the minds of the offensive guys. What do we do? Because now you don't have a go-to play. Either side,
well, I was right there.
Throwing it, running it, it won't be easy.
This defense bending but not breaking. It's a gain of 3. It's now fourth and goal. They've got the comfortable lead. Decision time here. Do they go for it? Press their luck?
Listen, if I'm the head coach, I take my headset off. I turn to my defense and say, guess what, guys? We're going for it right here, right now. I want the knockout shot. And if it doesn't happen, you've got my back, don't you? Go get it.
And if you don't get it, the other offense, they've got a long way to go in the other direction. So now the field goal unit trots out there for the third time tonight. From the right hash at a bit of a tight angle.
And the hit, the 3-point is
good. And his kick is good. And the lead opens up now 21-0. So he's been a busy man here in this first half. That's 3 field goals for him now.
And not just 3 field goals, but 3 for 3. So even though the offense has struggled a bit putting it in the end zone, he's still been able to come away with points due to his leg.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Fielded about a yard deep. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. And as this offense makes their way back out, it's AFC playoff race time as we give you a look. And this, you'd hate to say that a drive in the first half must end in points, but you're down 21-0. They're going to have to get something going fairly quickly.
I would agree totally with that, because if you're going to mount the comeback, it's going to have to come in bits and pieces. It doesn't just all come at one time, right? We haven't seen anything more than a six-point touchdown ever in this game, right? So that's how it has to be done. Get points on the board now. Start your comeback. But you're exactly right. Let's get it going right here in this spot.
Four yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six. Now it's Haskins. And he fires one that's intercepted.
How many times have
they... The return will stop right around the 25. And he may want to track down that football, because that's interception number one on his career.
You're saying that's going into the trophy case?
I put it there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. That's when you ask the equipment guys to make sure they hold it for you after the game. But if you play in the back seven on defense, that's part of your job, finding ways to take the ball away from the other team.
The offense takes the field, and we turn our attention to Saquon Barkley. The passing game, they've had more success there than the running game. Maybe something they game plan for.
How come they didn't tell us about it?
Because they wanted to keep it a secret.
We did ask, didn't we? But I think what happened in this one is they've realized that they've established the run pretty well, and teams are going to key on that. They thought they could open it up and have success through the air, and that's exactly what's going on.
Yeah, they've had success, at least so far here in the second quarter.
Woo!
And that'll be interception. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. So the pass incomplete in the end zone, but contact and pass interference.
And now where does the ball get placed?
At the one-yard line.
One-yard line. They gave up excellent real estate on that one. That's going to work really, really well for the guys who threw it.
Suddenly, it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. After the penalty, they go with Barkley.
Dog, I'm going to let me get a goddamn touchdown. Running touchdown.
It's a loss of four on the first down play.
But with the kind of half he's had, I think we can forgive him that run, right? Not every run's going to be a big play, is it?
No, and also the blocking just wasn't there. No room to run.
Yeah, defensively, they got to find a way to build on that, because he's eating them alive in the first half.
Now from the nine, here's second and goal. Another try for Barkley.
Almost there. Touchdown.
Into the end zone for a Giants touchdown. Saquon Barkley on his way to a monster game. Three first half touchdowns. And the Giants are able to add on to their lead.
Brandon, my man, just one sentence for that one. Clinic.
And that's what they've done. They lead the league in points per game this season, but it's been quick strike ability, as we saw on that drive.
I think they're actually intimidating defenses, because they're back on their heels right away, wondering where it's going to come from, how they're going to hit them. This group is well organized, well coached, and extremely confident in what they do.
Now the extra point try forthcoming. So he missed his first two, but this time it's good, and that'll extend the lead. Well, that drive started with not a whole lot of real estate in front of them. In plus territory, excellent field position. Two plays later, pay dirt. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This is fielded at the goal line. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Now we get a peek at the captain of this offense heading back out there. And he has not really been able to have a lot of comfort back there in the pocket. Pressure's been coming at him a lot, hasn't it?
And they've got to figure out how to tamp down that pressure. How do they decrease it? Is it getting rid of the football quicker? You know, shorter drops? Maybe they do something different with their pass blocking and their protection schemes. Maybe you meet them on the line of scrimmage instead of retreating to try and protect your quarterback. They've got to figure something out, though, because you cannot let your guy get hit that much, not if you intend to win.
Yeah, I know they'd like to erase that video and those four sacks that they've seen so far. An ideal beginning of the drive there as they'll get 20 and a first down.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of their yardage has come through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
One play has him up past the 40 already and another first and 10. On first and 10, it's Haskins. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. And the play goes nowhere, losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. Well, they try to swing it out left into the flat, complete, but really nice open field tackling.
And they played that one like a great boxer. They were on their toes on that one. They weren't back on their heels reacting to the play. No, they saw it, came right for it, and made a nice tackle for lost yardage.
Second and 12 after the first down pass play went backwards for 2 yards. On second down, here's Haskins looking for McLaurin, and he's got him. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down.
Partney sold the go route really well. Thought he was going deep, then curled it back inside for a nice completion.
DBs love when they pump the brakes, don't they?
Yeah, that's really a whole lot cool. Of fun. It's almost like you said, listen, if you're going to sell the go, just go, and let's see who's faster. You got nothing to win. Ready, go.
They go play action with Haskins. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 4, good enough to earn him yet another first down.
At first glance, I thought he just used his size in order to win the route. But he also had a little subtle move in there as well. Made the defender think he was going one direction and was able to track the ball in another.
Haskins now, after the pick on the last drive, 3 for 3 to start this drive. It's first and 10. On the ground, it's Geis. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between 2nd and 4 and 2nd and 8 and 9.
The last run got 6. Now 2nd and 4.
Let's go, D. Big series right here. We got to step it up.
Geis. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it will go as a 1-yard loss, and that's going to lead to a 3rd down. He came out ready to play. That's 3 tackles for a loss, Charles, rolling the 2nd quarter.
And that's problematic for the guys trying to run offense because that means he's got a pretty good idea of what they're doing and is actually beating them to the point of attack and making those plays. Might have to think about some misdirection or something to try and get him away from the ball.
The Redskins on 3rd down. They've converted 3 times and 8 chances. This will be 3rd and 5. Now it's Haskins. Well, the two men come together, and it's incomplete. Excellent work defensively brings up fourth down. Well, the other day they told us when we've got third and five or less, we have to be able to convert. And I guess every team would say that, Charles, but an opportunity missed there.
What they were trying to tell us is they believe it's a matchup game at that point. And they liked some matchups that they had, thought they could exploit them, unable to do so on that play.
Here's Jake Elliott. Career long, by the way, for him, 61 yards. They'll spot it at the 47, so call it a 57-yard attempt. And this kick is not going to be close. It's well short, well right to boot. And this score will stay right where it is. It was a kicker from that distance, 56, 57 yards. So many things you got to worry about. But I am a little surprised he didn't get it there.
Yeah, with the way kickers are nowadays, we're surprised anything under 65 that it doesn't get at least to the crossbar. But remember this, you have to drive it a little bit lower in order to make that distance, and you also have to be worried about the interior rush that they can get their hands on it. So that's why those stronger kickers nowadays who can pop it up in the air and still travel and carry it, that's what you're looking for.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts of the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the left.
Wait, touchdown!
Down the right side! Touchdown, Giants! A big play there! With touchdown number 29, two short of LaDainian Tomlinson's all-time record 31. As his guys continue to put this one out of reach.
What the hell, shit?
Now, these have been no picnic for him so far. He's missed two, but this one is good. And they're able to get the connection on the long touchdown pass. And that's one of the easiest drive summaries you'll ever see. One play, touchdown. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. As this unit comes back out there, let's focus in on Darius Geis. And he's closing in on that number that all running backs circled beginning of the year, the number 1,000. Could do it on this drive.
And you have to think to yourself that this moment, getting to this spot, it started in the offseason, right? Not just the workouts, right? Not just getting yourself physically prepared to play, but mentally, as well as your team, as well as your unit, head coach, offensive coordinator. We run the football. We give you opportunities. He's taking advantage of it.
And when you get this close to the mark, you just hope things don't tighten up, right? You probably want to get there and get it in your rearview mirror.
You really do, don't you? Because now it becomes predominant, and you wonder about play calling as well. Do you want to call plays to get that out of the way, or are you still calling plays to win the game first? That becomes the burden of the play caller.
And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what?
You're going to have to show how to do it.
I'd like to keep carrying it. Thank you.
The Redskins on third down. They've converted a third of their opportunities, 3 for 9. This time it's third and three. Haskins will throw, and that's knocked away and incomplete.
Well, it's looking like another three and out here, and at some point, got to be able to put together a drive to keep your defense from having to go right back out on the field. I feel like things are starting to unravel a little bit, and we're not even at halftime.
Here's Tressway now, as he's on to punt for the fourth time tonight.
I can see why the Redskins are screaming
at
Lovey.
He'll get this away into the icy winter air. This is taken.
They had
the 15.
Three fumbles, one interception.
That'll be put the only thing they got going for them is
the fact that they blocked one of my kicks.
Football first and 10. And New York set to take the field. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right?
Why
in your playbook,
do everybody forget
exactly
my
what you want on offense. But they
it
have
ain't
to be
that
careful.
Hard.
It's not having a letdown. It was really easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
And we'll see if it's that easy here. A nice looking play to start the drive down the middle.
Bro,
and
if he wanted
that
throw, he would have went all the way.
Just shy of the 45-yard line. Great way to start the drive. 20 big ones and a first down.
I think it all came together there. In-breaking route. Drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
This quarterback now over 200 yards already in this first half. It's first and 10. He'll look to throw. Looking for Shepherd deep. Into double coverage and it's intercepted.
My first interception
of the game. Picked off at the 20. And he will take this all the way up past the 40-yard line.
Well, if you go by the numbers, you'll find as the temperature goes down, so does the passing efficiency. And now that we're in December, even the routine throws are going to be harder for the quarterbacks. And this one, it winds up getting picked off.
A look at Washington as they come onto the field. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
Good starting field position for him as they come up first and 10 at the 41-yard line. And the drive begins with a run by Geis. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
Now a run with Geis. And he'll get three up to midfield.
So many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things. But the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blow. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
He's exceeded his receiving yards from a week ago, and we're still in the first half. It's a first down.
But that's what you're looking for when you want to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
Haskins looking to throw on first down. Looking left sideline, incomplete.
Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he led him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground, incomplete.
Ball on the 42 as they come up second and 10.
Hey, four down.
Again on second and 10, it's Haskins. Able to find his running back, Geis. And he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And that's going to lead to a third and 12. A pass for negative yardage, obviously no good. Maybe he shouldn't have thrown it, or maybe he shouldn't have caught it.
I think we were seeing it at the same time, weren't we? Maybe you let that one go, right? Because you can see the lost yardage about to develop. But that goes against every instinct of a receiver. They're taught to catch everything. So it's really hard to be mad at him and yell at him for trying to make that play.
The last catch took him 2 yards in the wrong direction, so now what can they do on third? Haskins back to the air. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he can only manage to take this thing to the 38, well shy of the first down.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks, don't let them get there, and they've rallied and made the tackle.
And for the second time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. This officially a 55-yard attempt. And he has got it from 55 yards away. That was never in doubt. These kickers now, it used to be that a 50-plus yarder was cause for celebration. Now, seemingly automatic.
Yeah, isn't it funny? When we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find out they were All-State quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs, All-State wrestlers, right? Baseball players. We're finding athletes all along, and now they're
still getting blown out,
putting it through the posts.
Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Here again comes the captain of this offense, leading his crew back out there now. He's got the lead here in the second quarter. He's thrown the touchdown, but also an interception. As a quarterback, does that interception, even though you're playing well, your team's got the lead, does that always stick in the back of your mind a little bit?
For the best ones, it just upsets them that they did that because they don't think there should be any blemishes on their record. They think that they're way better than that. So your confidence gets tested.
Ooh, I go all the way.
Being able to go.
I'm going all the way. All the way. Touchdown.
And touchdown, New York. Saquon Barkley.
Let's go, Barkley.
First half touchdowns as his guys continue to pour it on. Now you talk about the dominating rushing performances that you and I have seen together. This has got to be right up there. His fourth touchdown run of the game and another long one to boot.
And I don't need to ask for a witness because you're right here with me. We are watching this, and we're watching such a performance that is demoralizing for anyone on defense. You know, it starts out, coaches screaming, tackle him, get him. And after that last touchdown, I bet it's pure silence on that side of the ball.
Extra point splits the uprights, and a rout is on here in this first half. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. As this unit comes back out there, let's focus in on Darius Geis. He's been good. They've utilized him well, but they're losing here in the second quarter. What might they change offensively?
I think that what you try and do is expand how you get the ball to him a little bit. Get him out in open space, maybe swing the ball to him. What's that they used to call it in the West Coast offense, the long handoff?
Yeah.
Serve as your running play that way, as well as continue to feed him the football. Some of these runs now may pop bigger later in the game because of the effects of running it. Sometimes people, after a while, they don't want to tackle him anymore, or they get tired, or they get out of position, or he runs through tackles. Continue to feed him the ball. He's having that kind of game.
Yeah, might they get him the ball in some space in some different ways here?
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13. Now Haskins to throw it. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. Kelvin Harmon, the man he was looking for, and it's third down.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end. Pass rush, they've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync, only way to play good defense.
Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect. Not much going on this drive. Looks like they're going to have to punt it away, CD.
And right now, I know a lot of their fans are screaming for the OC to change things up, get away from what he's been calling. Sometimes you just need better execution of the plays that have been called.
Here's Tressway now, as he'll come on for his fifth kick of the night. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. This is brought in at the 21.
Y'all ain't catching me. Y'all ain't catching. Oh, y'all caught me.
A very nice job on the run back there. He'll get 23 yards all told. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Now out comes their leader and the captain of this offense back onto the field. They've sort of epitomized balance. I mean, he's thrown the ball pretty well. They've run the ball well. Got to be pretty happy over on that sideline.
Takes a lot of pressure off, doesn't it? As much as those guys back there want to throw the ball around and be the focal point, when you're able to run it well and hold the defense back from the pass rush, it allows you to throw it as well as
we're seeing. Let's go! Touchdown!
Touchdown, Giants!
Let's go!
Becoming just the second player with 30 touchdowns in a single year.
Damn, I never won a Super Bowl since 2011.
As his guys continue to put this one out of reach.
Yeah, 2023, my boy.
Extra point right down the middle. And the route is on here in this first half. And we can break that scoring drive down pretty easily. One play, long touchdown pass into the end zone. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Out comes Washington's offense as they get set to take over here. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Haskins and the Redskins come up first and 10 at their own 23. Throwing now, Haskins on first down. And his throw here is incomplete.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but only the second quarter, a lot of time to change things. Once again, they'll go from the 23-yard line on second and 10. Second and 10. Here's Haskins again. And he comes back with one complete. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. These guys have punted four times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. On the handoff, it's Geis. That is not going to be any help as they dump him behind the line of scrimmage. That'll set him back with a loss of three on the play. And that'll bring up fourth down. Well, he had two sacks earlier. Now he has four total tackles for a loss after that play.
Well, they obviously have to do a better job trying to block it. But short of that, you know what the quarterback has to do? Make sure he doesn't hand it to him when he's back there thinking he's one of his own guys. His quickness, his suddenness, his speed getting into the offense's backfield has been something else in this game.
Here's Tressway now. He's been one of their few bright spots so far. Averaging 50 yards a boot so far as this one's away. And we'll see what he can do on the return. Oh, he shifts past him.
Did he just jump over him?
Return there, 17 yards. And out will come the offense as they take over. Out comes this field general once more, leading his offense back onto the field. He's been in a pretty good group. They actually have more yards on the ground than through the air, but both have been good, pretty balanced.
And have we ever met a coach when we've talked to him before a game that hasn't mentioned wanting to be balanced?
No, because then you've got both sides hitting the defense. They don't know what to expect, right?
Really helps your play calling because now you're in a position where you're confident in either one, either aspect of the game. dial it up, and let it go. And so far, that's allowed them to lead.
Absolutely. Have the lead here in the second quarter. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33.
I'm coming, baby. I'm coming, baby. Woo!
They'll start out on the ground. It's Saquon Barkley. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. On second down now, Barkley.
Why is that even a thing?
For one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain there, and now they're looking at a 3rd and 13.
Perfectly designed blitz right there. They took that one from the grease board to the field because they were able to free up their linebacker to get into the backfield and spill the play.
To about the 35, well short of the line to gain. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and it'll bring up a 4th down.
We often talk of situational football. Let's just call it team football. The defense did their job, got off the field, brought up a punting situation, so they're turning the ball back over to their offense. You think those guys will get along very well right now? Of course they will. Defense helped the offense. Now it's their turn to take it downfield. That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. Well, what's the plan of attack here? Very late second quarter, and look where the ball is.
Yeah, bad spot for you. But the defense has all 3 timeouts. So what you're telling your team is, ball security, number one. It's not all on the running backs if you decide to run the football. That offensive line has got to protect up and wedge out some space because you can't just kneel. They take 3 timeouts. They're going to get the ball back in good field position with a chance to put points on the board. You've got to try and get a 1st down and run out this 1st half.
Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's 2nd and 10. Now Haskins to throw on 2nd down. That's complete to his receiver, McLaurin. Now Washington going to use the 2nd of their 3 timeouts as the clock stops here with 46 seconds remaining in the 1st half. These guys have punted 4 times already, and they're staring at a 5th, barring a conversion here on 3rd down. Haskins on 3rd down. This one complete to Kelvin Harmon. And he's going to get the 1st down as they bring him down at the 23. On 1st down, it's Haskins. Got an open man, it's Harmon. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll bring up a 2nd and 11. So we've reached halftime here in what is quickly turning into quite a rout. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome in, everyone, to our EA Sports Halftime Report. Let's get you caught up on what's going on around the NFL. We'll get started down at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami, where you see the final score there. 28-16, your final. Next, we head off to check out another game. And they were losers in that one to the visiting Houston Texans. 19-3, the final score. And finally, on Monday Night Football, should be a good one there between the Carolina Panthers and the Green Bay Packers. Meanwhile, in our game, it's been a back-and-forth first half. Who can put it together in the second half? For the answer, we turn it back over to our broadcast team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
So who's just going to freeze?
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Second half ready to get rolling. The Giants with a lead, and they are set to receive this kick. This is taken at the three. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Let's go! And New York set to take the field. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Now a play fake here on first down. Rush
I got
coming,
that.
And he's taken down. Matt Ioannidis able to record his fifth sack of the season.
Well, partner, we know they came out of the locker room down on the scoreboard, but I will guarantee you, the defensive side of the ball got super emotional. They can come out and play with aggressiveness, with fury, because they don't have to be quite as precise, and it paid off for them on that play, didn't it?
Sure did. Excellent play, really setting the tone for this third quarter. So after the sack, they'll come up on a still manageable second and 13.
I am distracted in this game. I'm surprised I'm still winning. Oh! Oh! That's a move!
Taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. It's a gain of 34.
And having built that kind of a lead, they're able to do whatever they want right now. All momentum on their side, especially now running the football.
Yeah, you're talking about a defense being on their toes. They don't know what's going to hit them next at this point.
No, they went from toes to heels, and they're trying to figure out how to get back to the toes part.
So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. This is Barkley. Treads the tackle. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead, give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. They'll let this go for the end zone.
Oh, so
close. This is going to wind up incomplete. The coverage there too strong on the deep ball, and now they face a third down. They come up now third and 5 following the incomplete pass. Back to throw. And he's going to be sacked.
And I got sacked again.
At the midfield stripe. And they went empty backfield, and because of that, nobody was there to pick up the blitz.
And you know that offenses, when they go with the empty backfield, they have different things designed on every play to try to account for things. But what people often forget, defense is audible as well. And a lot of times when they see an empty backfield, they audible right into a blitzing situation.
Here's Riley Dixon now, as he's on to punt for New York. So now we look at the Redskins offense getting ready for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half,
Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
So much of the game today, we're looking for hybrid players, guys who can do a combination of jobs. And anyone who plays a strong safety position, now more than ever, is a hybrid type player. Half defensive back that covers passes and half linebacker that makes tackles. We just saw the linebacker make that play.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Khalil Mack in there yet again. What else is new? He continues to rewrite the record book in single season sacks.
So one quick, easy analysis about why they've struggled so far. They keep putting themselves in 3rd and long situations. They just took another sack right there.
And the offensive film session tomorrow may be a little longer than it normally is.
Not a lot of positive grades will be handed out thus far.
These guys have punted 4 times already, and they're staring at a 5th, barring a conversion here on 3rd down. Now Haskins. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down.
Love this one.
Khalil Mack. Make that now 4 sacks for him in tonight's ball game.
It's been a tough one all game long for this offensive line. They're already down big, and now you know they're just going to come after the quarterback in a big way, don't you?
Yeah, they just can't get out of their own way right now. It's created an avalanche, and an avalanche is coming right on top of them. Here's Tressway now as the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Averaging over 50 yards a punt so far as this one's away. Fielded at the 33. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And possession will switch hands, 1st and 10. The New York set to take the field. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
Good starting field position for them here as they come up 1st and 10 at the 41-yard line. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. That's caught by his tight end, Evan Ingram. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. It's a gain of 11 and a giant 1st down.
One of the advantages of zone defense, as I remember it, is being able to see the play develop in front of you. One of the disadvantages, when they find those levels where they can hit you with it, sometimes behind the corner and in front of the safety, it makes it tough to defend.
This quarterback now hitting on 2/3 of his passes, 10 for 15 so far, 1st and 10. They'll run with Barkley. Oh, look at the juke.
Too many jukes. What I get you?
Part, I remember a coaching friend of mine used to tell his running backs before games, make sure you run and jog with your offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking when those big behemoths start to create space for you up front. He did a pretty good job of just following those guys through there for a nice explosive run.
They'll go to Barkley again. And an alley to run.
On his 1st down.
And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, 1st down.
3rd quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
From the 34 now, here's 1st and 10. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And lucky to get away with one there. That one nearly picked. 2nd down. By the way, I got to apologize because I just realized for about the last four or five plays, I'm eking over into your territory up here in the booth. My bad. I'm going to get back over to my spot.
Yeah, we're not talking about our on-air commentary. I mean, what is all this extra paper? I mean, this is unusual for you.
My bad.
Normally, you run a really tight ship. What's going on here?
Just like that incomplete pass, I'm going to try to tighten things up here for this next play. Now a man open down the middle of the field. And they're going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Redskins 23. And he's certainly been a huge factor in this one. He's got the two touchdowns to his credit. Now they look to him again. He picks up the first.
Yeah, I can hear everyone saying, well, why don't you cover him, double him, triple him, do what you have to do. But sometimes they get locked into such a groove and such a connection, it doesn't matter how many guys are in his area.
He certainly looks to be in that groove right now. This quarterback now 11 of 17 passing thus far. He's got his guys a first and 10. They go back to the ground now with Barkley. And able to get about three as he's taken down right at the 20.
Well, praise has to go to the guys in the offensive line because they've had a very nice, productive day running the football. How about that poor defensive line? They've been knocked around the entire game, and while they slowed them down on that run, can they continue to do so? Because they haven't had much success throughout this ballgame.
Again, it's Barkley.
Hey, why is there a flag?
With a penalty flag on the field.
Huh?
So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
In your face. It's always a defender, I swear to God.
Oh, on second down, Laird.
And another touchdown.
For a giant touchdown. A great effort there. His 11th touchdown of the year as his guys continue to pour it on. And on his way to the end zone, shedding the tackle, he would not be denied.
That's what's called finishing the run, making sure you power your way through. One-on-one tackle, no running back wants to go to the bench and say, I got stopped just short.
Extra point attempt to come here. And the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. So that winds up a seven-play drive all told. And a long run there in the end to top it off. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Redskins offense now, they get set to take over here. They have been struggling. I would imagine at halftime they went through some possible changes. Well, those changes aren't working, so now where do you go?
I think that now it's much more in their head. And what I mean by that is just what you said. You've gone over the changes. I bet they were pretty clinical at the half, not too emotional. They might need to go to the emotional side because you've got to find something, some spark somewhere. And so far, just being calm hasn't exactly worked.
They need any spark at this point. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
Anytime you call an inside running play, you just know there should be a lot of congestion there. You're counting on your offensive line to take control of the line of scrimmage. That didn't happen in this case, and that play got bottled up.
Opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. Second down, Haskins. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And down he'll go at the 25.
And partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal. Because everything was right, got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
These guys have punted four times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. Third down, here's Haskins. Now they set up the screen, that's complete. The screen good for six, but it's not enough as it leads to a fourth down.
They dialed up the screen pass on third down, and for a second it looked like it was all going to come together, and they had a chance to pick up a first down, but the defense got there and finished it off.
Here's Tressway now. He's been terrific so far. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And now where will the side judge stop his walk? That's the question. He says it crossed out of bounds at about the 17-yard line. And New York set to take the field. And last time out, another touchdown. And I think there may be some empty seats around here by the time the fourth quarter comes around.
Yeah, I have to agree with you because this one's just about decided. But you know who benefits from all those empty seats?
Who?
You and me, trying to get to the airport.
That's
the roads
true.
Will be fairly
that,
clear
that is
by the
one
time
positive.
We have to leave the booth.
They begin with a run by Barkley. And for one of the first times all night, he is going to go nowhere as they bury him behind the line. That's going to go as a loss of four, and it'll be second down. Well, from my vantage point, that's just one bad play by the offensive line and a running back who's had a lot of good ones tonight.
Yeah, but that doesn't mean he's not going to be ticked off, nor is the offensive line, because to me it's a lot like a no-hitter, right? Pitcher's throwing a no-hitter, gives up a hit late. You're so close to accomplishing everything you want and don't quite get it done. They'll come back with a vengeance on the next play.
Second and 14. And he's going to go down right near the
goal. Where is my protection?
They're going to mark him at the 1 yard line.
All right, let's go ahead and detail this situation here. Third long coming up, back near your own goal line. I would be very hesitant about throwing the football in this situation.
Maybe just run up the middle?
Yeah, I think that might be the spot for them. You got to try and find some space for your punter because you don't want him backed up where he has to alter what he does.
All right.
After the sack, they'll come up now, third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
And instead, they want to throw it off play action, finding Sterling Shepard for his first catch. It's a gain of 11, but they're still well short. It's fourth down. So they wind up throwing it against your advice, but the result's still a fourth down.
Well, it did turn out to be a safe throw. And you know how sometimes coaches talk about using short passing game as a run? Essentially, that's what they did there. Now they can kick it away.
Here's Riley Dixon now, standing about a yard deep in his own end zone. His first punt, 48 yards. This one looks equally as good. 51 yards on the punt there. And it'll be Redskins football now with a first and 10. So out now come the Redskins. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough, because we always talk about it being a team game, and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who can make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers. They probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're used to touching the football that makes big plays and give them that opportunity to maybe wake up everyone else.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. On second down, here's Haskins looking for McLaurin, and he's got him. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 10 yards there, good for a Redskin first down. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7.
What's the old expression? 3 yards in a cloud of dust? In this case, it's dust-covered pellets. It's no longer that old grass that we used to play on, right, and chew it up. Now we've got that artificial surface. You see the pellets go up. Still a nice play by the defense.
On second and 7, Haskins nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Khalil Mack, my goodness, make that now 5 sacks for him in this ball game. Really, really turning in an incredible performance.
This offensive line flat out cannot handle this pass rush. We've seen it demonstrated time and time again, to the tune of 7 sacks in this game thus far.
These guys have punted 4 times already, and they're staring at a 5th, barring a conversion here on 3rd down. Play action, Haskins. The pressure gets to him again. Khalil Mack in there to get him again. That is sack number 6, 1 off the NFL record of 7.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Here's Tressway now, as he's on to punt for Washington. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. And did they keep it in? They did. They kept it in. It's down close to the goal line at the 1-yard line. Amazing. Perfectly placed. If that ball goes 1 extra yard, maybe not even an extra yard, the starting point is the 20.
So there is a reason that a lot of punters are also excellent golfers. They know distance control. You know what else they have? Same groove motion over and over. Once they have that down, it repeats under pressure.
Now a first carry for their fullback. And he's able to get him a small cushion before being taken down at the 5, a gain of 3. On second down, here's Barkley. And he'll get it up to the 12-yard line here.
And that's a nice pickup of the first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that plan any down.
On play action, they'll throw. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the... He's got a man, complete!
And that's even better.
A gain of 35. What a game it's been for this duo.
They remind me of a good comedy team. They know how to play off of each other so well. No matter how one riffs, the other's right there to pick them up, and they are shredding them in this ballgame.
The big play has him all the way out near midfield for a first and 10. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
Another sack. Where is my
criticism there? Because it went right back to the air after the huge pickup and ended up getting sacked. That's often a play that you make. You feel like you've got momentum on your side.
Unfortunately, the O-line failed to hold up to try to keep that momentum going. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. On the draw, this is Barkley. Now Barkley stripped of the football, and the Redskins scoop it, and to the 43, so down inside the 45 to the 43-yard line, that's where they'll take over. So the defense there, opportunistic.
It's nice to give them credit, isn't it? Because so many times it's more a matter of what the offensive guy didn't do. Didn't secure the ball, didn't cover up. In this case, just give credit to where it belongs. Knocked it free, made a big play.
Comes Washington's offense as they get set to take over here. And right now these guys, they're shuffling a little bit, maybe doubting, because three straight drives have ended with them punting the football away.
Yeah, so you start pointing fingers at each other a little bit, asking a lot of questions. What are you seeing? What are you getting? Maybe trying to narrow down your playbook a little bit and maybe get simpler rather than more complex in order to try and fashion together a drive.
They'll try to get this running game going with Geis. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. It's a first down for the Redskins on a pickup of 11. Well, CD, a lot of times like to separate speed and quickness, and they've got a back that's both. We know that he's fast and in the open field, but man, his first step is so quick, too.
It is something, isn't it? Because you think of that type of speed getting to the perimeter and turning upfield, but also when you run those inside runs, he can get into the secondary so fast, the linebackers don't have a chance to react.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10.
Double dog, that's the way.
They'll run it now, out of the gun. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
The previous run, good for 9. Here's second and a yard. They'll keep it on the ground. Seymour, and he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. One quarter remains here on a Sunday night, and that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. And 5 in the secondary now for the Giants on third down. From the gun, Haskins on third down.
Interception!
And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent, and now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
And a As this offense makes their way back out, NFC playoff race time. We give you a look at what's going on there. And you can see they're in second place in the division, but they have clinched postseason football. They have the best record among the wild card contenders, but you never really feel comfortable when you're down around that 5 or 6 slot, do you?
No, you don't. You figure you've got to close the deal. You've got to make sure you clinch that spot to make sure you keep your place in the tournament, in the playoffs. But the other part, too, is the coaching staff. All year they've talked about getting a high seed, clinching home field. Now that talk changes to, hey, we're in. That's all that matters. Let's go on the road and take care of business.
13 yards, good for a Giant first down.
I like how they worked the tight end on a nice little under route there. And if you're going to give him that much space, he's not even going to catch the football. He's going to run away from you a little bit. And that's exactly what he just did there, picking up extra yardage.
This quarterback now perfect since the second half started. 7 of 7. It's 1st and 10. Back to throw here. This one into the hands of Metcalf. And he'll be upended here after a pickup of 3, getting it out to the 25. That first down completion only netted him 3. 2nd and 7.
What, the Eagles are 4-11?
Here's a 2nd and 7. He's got his man on the crossing route. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
So much goes into a successful play, like that, doesn't it? How about that play action there? Freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
They go play action here on 1st down. He'll find Metcalf. Just a yard on the catch there. It'll be 2nd and 9.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there were more people there to get him down.
2nd and 9 now. And he finds a man with a crossing
route. No, flying.
Another mistake here defensively as a flag is down on the tackle, and that's going to tack on 15 more. So they'll take the yardage and tack on 15 more for the face mask.
Talk about a play that absolutely costs you in the
no
end.
No wonder you're
just trying to do your job, right? Trying to get him on the ground. Next thing you know, they march off another 15 against your squad.
So the face mask, quite a blessing there as they'll start out of harm's way with a 1st and 10. He'll look to throw. And his throw here is going to be incomplete. Well, the incompletion there stops the clock. Any surprise they're throwing here late?
Ordinarily, yes, because you would think enough is enough. They've got plenty of lead. But I've seen this a bunch of times as well. The defense is going to crowd the line of scrimmage. If you just hand it off inside, you're getting your running back popped a lot as well. Sometimes the defense dictates it. If they're going to crowd it, you may have no other choice but to throw it downfield.
Back to throw now on 2nd and 10. He's going to rifle one, and this is caught inside.
Well, definitely wasn't about to sack me again. Nope.
It's a big-time play there for the G-men. 42 yards. Boy, another big play late here for an offense, Charles, that certainly has had its fair share of big plays.
Coverage has been a problem all game long, and I would say that going along with that has been confidence, because even if they had the right coverage, they've still dented them, and now it's been a real issue for them during this game.
After the big play, a chance to finish now on 1st and goal. Try to run this one in. And he is in.
Touchdown, Giants.
A 3-yard touchdown run.
Because that one's got the puller. Maybe take the puller timeout.
Now the try here for the point after.
Let's get any questions anyway.
Now this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. So that drives 7 plays in length. And the rookie Saquon Barkley, the one who finishes things off with a touchdown run. Kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been had he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. Now the Redskins offense, they get set to go back to work here. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. The completion good for 3, and it's second down. Here's 2nd and 7 now from the 28.
You're going to see me in your nightmare, son.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And this will go for 5 up to the 33.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. You'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
Third and 2, now Haskins. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Khalil Mack in there for the 7th time in this game alone, and that ties him with a late Derek Thomas for the most sacks ever in a single game.
That right now, that's a defeated team out there. I think you can see it totally in their body language.
Hands on hips, heads low. It's just been a struggle from the start.
Yeah, this team has been thoroughly beaten right from the word go.
Here's Tressway now as he's on to punt for Washington. And this will be taken at the 13. They'll call that a punt of 59 yards. Tough to do better than that. And it'll be Giant football 1st and 10. And New York set to take the field. And Charles, we are in the midst of a very one-sided affair. I think this is where you and I have to fill a little bit. You want to regale us with old stories of your childhood in New Paltz, New York?
I don't think anyone wants to hear that, but this is a perfect time for us to start listing MVP candidates, right? The best teams we've seen so far this year. The best games that we've called thus far. How we anticipate the season unfolding. We can go in so many different directions. Because the game certainly not taking us there.
Oh, I hear the remotes clicking off right now. On the run, it's Barkley. 2nd down, a little more productive than first. 7 yards on the gain. It gets him to 3rd and 3 now. The Giants on 3rd down. As bad as you can be. 0-for-7 thus far. Here it's 3rd and 3.
Yeah, who doesn't want to talk about?
They'll run it again with Barkley. He'll have a 1st down past the 40. And he's got it across the 50 to the 47-yard line. Good yardage as he rumbles for 24 and a 1st.
He's still rumbling, isn't he? Still looking fresh in this one despite the heavy workload. But you and I both know, well-conditioned, and he did tell us that he thrives on being at his peak late in ball games.
In Washington territory now, here's 1st and 10 at the 47. Now a handoff here to his running back. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up 2nd down.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
For his career right there, and it's good enough to keep the chains moving. So now, following the big play, they've got a first and goal all the way down at the 10. Say you, Mr. Referee. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. After only a yard, taking it down to the 14.
And this is why aggressive defensive coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
Second down now, Barkley. And he's going to work this one down to about the 5. A sizable gain there, 9 yards as they get it back to a 3rd and 5. Well, lots of praise on this drive, obviously. I know you're seeing what I'm seeing. Those guys up front, they're getting it done.
Doesn't matter what play is called, they are handling their business at the line of scrimmage and dominating right now on this drive.
Keep it on the ground. Barkley. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. That'll set them back with a loss of 3 on the play. And that's going to bring up a 4th down. Finally, defensively, they have a little clip to show positive for actually stopping him running the football.
It's been a really long night for them, hasn't it? So they got a little bit of a win there. But let's face it, the vision that he's had running the football has carried his feet to the open spaces and to big yardage all night long.
So out comes the field goal team once more. From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. And his kick is good. And they're sitting pretty now as the lead
this
grows even
was
worse
than the Eagles.
So it's three more points, and that widens this thing out even further here in the fourth.
And you know, in this league, you can never have enough points, but this widens it out, as you said, and now it's all about ball control, isn't it?
The kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. And here come the Redskins now. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
Haskins and the Redskins come up first and 10 at their own 22. And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. Just nothing there again. He's been sacked multiple times. We've seen the interceptions, of course. He's really been through the ringer, hasn't he?
And what we've seen is a defense is well coordinated. The front and the back really in sync. The front putting on the pressure, the backside being ball hawks and picking passes off.
Second and 10 now, Haskins. And he's going to
play
this
man
out
of
the backfield. That's complete. They'll wind up losing three. And now it's third down. Really good defensive effort. They were all over that little swing pass out to the right side before loss yarded.
Terrific read, better execution, and done with a lot of enthusiasm, wasn't it?
Absolutely.
They saw it all the way, ran to the football, and caused a nice play for loss yardage.
That last catch winds up costing him three, so now they'll need to convert on third and 13. Now Haskins, third and long. And he will find his man on the outside. They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down.
He wasn't the primary target, but I think it was almost like a check down situation, wasn't it?
Yeah,
like
hoping he could break some tackles, a big tight end, but he couldn't do it.
Yeah, get it to that big frame and hope he could scatter some bodies, unable to get it done.
Here's Tressway now, as he's on to punt for Washington. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. They'll look to set up his blockers. 12 yards on the return that time, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Giants offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. We find ourselves here in the midst of a one-sided affair. A lot of fill time down the stretch, Mr. Davis.
So we could talk about food because that is something that you and I
enjoy. We share that.
We enjoy our time at the table. So maybe the best steakhouses in the city, but in all seriousness, the performances that we've seen this year, we've seen a bunch of great ones, and it's going to be hard to parse who's going to win the MVP.
Yeah, it really is.
Is it going to be a runner? Is it going to be a thrower? Can a defender finally win it this season? Those are the things that we could probably discuss.
And collectively, this is about as dominant of a performance as you could have hoped for on both sides of the football.
Might have to put it number one for what we've seen this season.
And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all three still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the 2-minute warning. Second down and inches. got his man on the crossing route. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. That one covers 29 yards, first down. Still throwing the football here, even with the big lead.
Yeah, I know you and I came up in a different era, and we think about sportsmanship and all that. Other people think about fantasy points and getting their numbers. That's all they care about right now.
In Washington territory now, here's first and 10 at the 36.
They're not ready for this. They still playing soccer. Y'all playing the wrong football.
Here's a give to Barkley.
Get in, boys. And I win.
Nothing doing. Barely able to muster a yard to hit the 35.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they want to put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
On second down, Laird. And we are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair. So it's Giants football here as we welcome you back. They've got a third down now as they look for one more first down to help salt this one away. They'll drop the throw. And he finds a man with a crossing route. And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25. Move the chains, a gain of 7 on third down. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way, it worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they've scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. That sends him 2 yards in the wrong direction and leads to second down.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage. A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's second and 12. They'll keep it on the ground. Barkley. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for the Giants, The wins keep coming as this one moves him to 12-3 on the year. And they'll hit the road next week to take on the Atlanta Falcons. Meanwhile, for Washington, the slide continues as they drop now to 3-12. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week.
All right, I'll be back.
That'll do it for us. I'm Brandon Gauden, alongside Charles Davis. Thanks to our entire crew as well. We'll talk to you next time. So long, everybody.